Hey everyone, welcome back. Today, the bundle shop has received a new feature, and I'd like to talk about that and give my two cents on it. We have something called the Party Pack, which is part of the Serial Killer skin, and the Party Skin bonus gives you XP bonuses when your party plays using the killer skins. You get double XP and double weapon XP. When you play together in parties of at least two players, you'll also get added double battle pass XP if you're in parties of three or more. And all of these people need to be using the killer skin in order for those benefits to apply. So effectively, this is giving you permanent double XP and double weapon XP. But if three or more of your friends buy the killer bundle and you all play together, then you also get double battle pass XP. I wonder if this stuff stacks on top of double XP tokens, effectively giving you quad XP. I'm not going to test it. I'm sure somebody out there will. And you know, the thing is, I don't know why anyone would want this. Why would you want this? This is like double XP and double weapon XP and double battle pass XP. It's the one thing that's carrying the seasons. It's the one thing that keeps people coming back to play. Ranking up is already capped. You get like a few weapons every season. And then once you get there, those are capped. There's no prestige mode on weapons anymore. You get your battle pass done, then you're done for the season. At this point, we are a stone throw away from just straight up having double XP tokens available in the shop a la carte for 250 COD points each. Like, it's bound to happen if we continue going in this direction. And I hate to break it to everybody, but we're gonna continue going in this direction, and it's gonna get worse and worse and worse. And I also need to say, the premium games are not free to play, unless you're talking Warzone only. Multiplayer is not free to play. This year, Zombies was not free to play. This is a type of bundle that you would see in Warzone Mobile. This is the type of bundle you'd see in Call of Duty Mobile. There's no reason to want to get to max rank as quickly as possible, because then you're stuck for, what, 30 days doing nothing, twiddling your thumbs, waiting for the next update? I just don't know, man. I really don't. I've never been at a loss for words before when it comes to things, because it's not that this bothers me, because I've already expected it. I already knew it was going to happen back in DMZ when we started seeing them add pay-to-win elements with UAVs and self-revives and armor plates that are attached to your skins. I already had that feeling in the pit of my stomach that something like this would happen, so it doesn't really surprise me. It's a slippery slope. Double XP tokens, probably, you know, like I said, a stone throw away from being in the shop. So I guess I'm really making this video just to get your opinions on it. What do you think about having bonus party skins? It's just weird to pay money to finish the season faster. And I think that it's kind of just due to how the gaming industry is right now. A lot of these games that are coming out, people really want to experience them, but for a lot of players that are still on Call of Duty, they're addicted to this game. It's very addicting. The gameplay loop is just so solid. But the thing is, they really, really drive it home that you're going to miss out if you're not here. So people want to finish up the things that they can and get it done and out of the way so they can move on to play other games. I kind of get it from that perspective, but at the same time, it's like, are you really enjoying it at that point? It's like it's turning into a transaction, even just logging in. And I think that's how every single game is becoming, slowly but surely. And it's, I don't know, it's made me do a lot of reflecting. I've realized, you know, as I've grown up, I've watched games that I've absolutely loved turn into things that I just can't really stand anymore. And that's just the nature of the gaming scene. It's not even a situation of just loving these games, because there are games that I still adore to this day. You know, more recently, like Final Fantasy VII Rebirth. Absolutely loved my time in that game, and I can't wait for the final iteration to come out. But multiplayer games, you know, the Battlefields, the Call of Duties, the, you know, even X Defiant, it's all going the same route. They're all copy-paste of each other, just with slightly different gameplay variations. The same type of monetization, the same type of subscription model, and it's just not fun anymore. It's something that I've just learned to detest. While I think the core of Call of Duty is still there and the core of many of these other games are still there, they've kind of lost their way in chasing the almighty dollar. And yeah, that's kind of where I'm at personally when it comes to my relationship with Call of Duty. I'm just not enjoying it anymore. I'm not enjoying my time. And, you know, there's very few things that really make me want to jump on the microphone and make a video because, you know, it's like I said at the beginning, this whole situation with this XP bonus, this isn't even shocking to me. And honestly, in my opinion, I think the real reason for doing this is because the PlayStation bonus XP for playing at a party is going to be going away after this game. It's no longer going to be there. It's no longer going to be a thing. So they no longer need to keep that going. They might as well monetize it now that it's going to be disappearing. And I get that it's still a thing in this game, but if it sells well, like I imagine it will, since it's coming in under 2,400 COD points, it's going to be 1,600 COD points, it's going to sell well. They're going to continue doing it into the future. It's going to happen in Treyarch's next game. It's going to continue to happen in Zombies. It's going to continue to happen in Warzone. And that slippery slope is going to keep slipping and the ball is going to keep rolling. And we're going to have to just see how far they end up taking it. But anyway, that's it. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Drop a like on this video if you enjoyed the commentary. I apologize for my demeanor in this video. Once again, it's not surprising to me. It's just very disappointing. Very, very disappointing. I can't believe that Call of Duty is still going in this direction. But they gotta chase the trends, I guess. They gotta chase the money. I get it. Thank you, guys. I'll see you on the next one. Peace.